Hello, welcome to my channel where I do guides for post-processing software for photography. Today we are inside OnePhotoRAW 2022 and I want to show you how easy it is to do blending. When I talk about blending, I'm talking about when you actually combine two different exposures of the same composition. So if you, for example, do bracketing and your neutral image is too bright in the highlights or something like that, then you might want to do blending. And I'm not talking about HDR here. I'm not talking about HDR inside OnePhotoRAW 2022. I'm actually talking just about blending two different exposures together. And we are going to do this image today. As you can see, it's overexposed. The sky is blown out and the image in itself is far too bright. But let's just do AI auto and try and develop this image before we start blending those images together. And I want to drop down the exposure on this one. Maybe drop, go up on the brightness. And I think that's fine. Let's have a look at the histogram. Yeah, it looks fine. Even it won't warn for these highlights, I think, even though it's not clipping, but we aren't going to be able to get a nice sky out of this image. So that's the reason why I want to blend two images together. This image is pretty flat actually, so let's just tweak it a bit more, dropping the exposure even more. I can do some adjustments later, but I'm going down just a bit there, and let's go up just a bit on the shadows instead. So somewhere around there, I think it's fine. And I need to have the same white balance on this image and the image that I'm going to use to blend in the sky. So I'm hitting auto on. And it's 5326, so I'm just gonna copy that. And we can bring up the vibrance quite a bit, I think, to something like that. But this is going to be my base image. So I want to develop this image, and this is what I'm going to use as my base. And I'm simply going to replace the sky. That's all I'm going to do. But I want to go up to mask and I want to create or mask the sky. And that's what it's doing now. It's calculating a lot of stuff, I guess. And as you can see, it removed the sky. Let's hit the plus button here and we are going to add a layer. And we are going to pick, I think it's not this image. It's this image, yeah, that's the image we are going to pick. And it loads up and we are going to do the same kind of process to this one, but we are going to move it to the bottom of that list. And you can see it looks a bit funky right now, but let's just tweak this image. I'm going to hit the auto on and let's just paint in the white balance instead here. So something like that. And we are going up a bit on the vibrance. Let's hit AI auto and that's starting to look good. So let's just enable this and let's go up on the top image here. And we need to fix some issues we have around here. So I'm going into the mask and we are going to just feather the mask a bit. And that actually helped a lot. So let's just view the mask here and you can see that we have a really soft feather here. I think we have some masking issue in the water here, so we are going to fix that. But yeah, this is starting to look good. So let's not view the mask anymore. Let's go out to fit view and I think it's actually looking quite nice. So we want to tweak this image. Let's see. No, it's fine. Let's tweak the top image instead. Let's just remove the sky. Yeah, it's fine. And we are going to make it just a bit more fancy. let's go up on the vibrance quite a bit. Yeah, let's drop the highlight just a bit, and maybe, no, let's not go up on the shadows, but we are going to go down even more on the exposure to somewhere around there. And I'm going to go into the effects, and we are going to add, for example, a glow filter. So let's do that. And what's happening now is that we are only applying that glow filter to this image. This image doesn't have any effects at all. So that's kind of stupid. So let's remove that glow filter, and we are going to right click up here, and we can make a new stamped layer. What that means is that it's combining those two layers into one layer. And we can go and tweak this layer instead. So let's go in another glow filter and hit the normal button. Now it is even applying a glow filter to the sky. And that's what we want. So let's see before, and this is after. To really make it obvious, let's just drop a tone enhancer and drop the exposure. As you can see, we are dropping the exposure for the entire image. And that's nice. Let's just reset this. But let's add some detail and some clarity. Something around there. And I'm going up on the shadows just a bit. Let's just remove this pane. Let's go in. Yeah, it's looking quite nice in the details. What else do we need to do? Let's go up there and let's go into develop, and I want to warm up the image just a bit there, do something like that, and that's fine. Let's go into the effects again, and let's just try some different modules here. We can try the dynamic contrast filter, and that brings out even more details. We have quite a bit of details up here. Yeah, we have quite a lot of details and textures up here, and I really like that, but it's a bit too much. Maybe we want to make the glow filter even a bit stronger. Let's go up on the amount there. So just softening down the image by doing this. You can also try the autumn clean or autumn hair sahoo, and that's quite nice. So, but I'm just gonna drop the opacity. Let's go up, and we are going to add a sunshine filter. If I can find it, there we are. And let's add a vignette and a big softy. And it's looking a bit crazy. So let's go up on the exposure just a bit and up on the shadows just a little bit. And yeah. Alright, so I think actually I'm going to remove the glow filter and tone enhancer, and I'm going to add a new glow filter, and we are going for normal, and that looks a bit better. Let's just go into the develop module, and I'm going to bring up the contrast and maybe add some blacks. Let's see. Yeah, we got some nice details here. I think I want to crop it. There's a bit too much dead space over here. So let's just go in and crop it. And we have freeform active, but I'm going to hit the original ratio. And I'm just going to pull this in. And maybe do something like this. Yeah, I think that's fine. Let's go back into the effects and let's add a vignette and big softy, and that's fine. Let's go to local adjustments, and we are just gonna brighten up this area here. So I want some more exposure and maybe up the shadows just a little bit. And let's just start painting in here. All right, so I think we need even more exposure. Something like that. So just want to highlight the brighter areas. This process is called dodge and burn, and right now we are dodging. That means we are brightening up parts of the image. And I'm not going to do a really good job here. I would spend a lot of time doing this and I would do pretty accurate masks. But in this case, in this video, we are just going to hurry up and do this. Now, if I were only doing the water, I would maybe add some whites. So let's try that, just a bit of whites there. Not too much, but something like that. And let's just do some burn as well. So darkening. So what dodge and burn is a process where you try to create a contrast between the brighter areas and the darker areas. So let's say this here, you can see that this is pretty bright and this is pretty dark. So if I apply some more dark on this or make it darker, you can see that it's a pretty big contrast between the two. And that's what dodge and burn is. And in landscape photos, you should probably learn how to do dodge and burn, because that's something that are used a lot and it makes the image pop just a bit more. And you might think that dodge and burn are something that we are only doing in digital photography, but that's not true. Anyway, I think it's quite nice. I think maybe the sky is just a bit too blue. So maybe I would add a color adjustment and fix that. So let's do that. Color adjustment is there. Let's go for the aqua. And I'm going to increase the range and increase the brightness. Let's do the same for the blues. Just increase the brightness there, and I can even desaturate some of the blues. Let's do the same for the aqua as well, and that should help a lot. Yeah, it does. We can even desaturate more on the blues there. Do something like that, and that really helped. So that's nice. So I guess if we disable this one, this is where we started, or actually this is where we started. And you can see we have removed the sky there. And then we dropped this under that image. And finally, we made a new stamped layer. And this is our result. It's a bit dark in the shadows. It's a bit overcooked, but this is just a demonstration to show you how extremely easy it's to do a blending of images inside of Omorang Photoraw 2022. It's really excellent. I love that you can actually go into the mask and mask the sky. And I've done so many bracketed photos, and that makes it so easy for me to blend images like that. Images where I first expose for the shadows and then I expose for the highlights, and then I can go home, simply go in, load up first image, go to mask and mask sky, and then add the second image as a layer, and then I've blended the photos. It's really excellent. I recommend you to try that. Try and do bracketed photos of the same subject, so with a different exposure value, and then head home and try to blend them together. The reason I like it is because HDR files, if you're merging HDR files, it sometimes looks a bit too fake. But I find that blending images in this way, it's more easy to get a really good and nice realistic image. And remember, again, even blending photos has been done for quite a few years. So it's not something new in digital photography. Alright, so I think that's this video. If you like this video, hit that like button. If you want to watch more from me, hit that subscribe button. And thanks a lot for watching, and I hope to see you again. Goodbye.